Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. This is Copenhagen Country coming to you with a install tutorial for LSPDFR version 0.4.9. I think this is the second version of LSPDFR and the latest version. What we're going to be doing here is we're going to be installing the things you need to get this actually into your GTA so you can play LSPDFR. As always, make sure you follow every step that I take, and you should have no problem playing this on your GTA 5. We will not be doing any plugins at this time. I'll be making other tutorials with plugins, going through the plugin with you, showing you what the plugins would do and all. Like I said, this is just for the install of LSPDFR version 0.4.9. And as always, Copenhagen Country is not responsible for your PC and or game file. Always mod at your own risk. Also recommend backing up your game files before following the tutorial. Thank you and enjoy the show. All right, a few housekeeping things to kind of get out of the way. As you can see rolling across the screen there, some of my social media sites that you can go to and follow. I highly recommend everybody joining my Discord. It is brand new. I will be putting plugins up there that you can download. I will be putting in support stuff. So if you have any questions, you need help with anything, post up there on my Discord. I will get to that quickly, and I will get it back quickly, and I will help you get this game installed. And if you have any issues, I'll help you get through your issues, try to work them out for you. Like I said, this is my first tutorial. Hope of many. Hope this goes well. It is new to me, but I do need to do tutorials so I can show people how to get things going. Let me move this out of the way, and I will show you how to go ahead and get started. Make sure, like I said, to follow everything I do, and it should get you loaded into the game like you need to be. Okay, a couple of things that we need to install, and I'm going to install them in order. So, first of all, we need to download this stuff. First thing you need to download is Simple Trainer for GTA 5. Colors she experiences in music, this is what it looks like. Library. It's going to be under the GTA 5 mod website. Like tempo and key. It is called Simple Trainer for GTA 5 version 13.6. What you want to do is you want to scroll down. You want to click on this here, join the 13.6 current version. Click on it, download it. If you have a screen pop up with an advertisement, just go back and click on it again and that'll go away. I don't know why it does that, but for this website, it does it. So just download it, put it on your desktop where you can get to it, because we're going to need it here in a few minutes. So after we get that one, we'll go to our next one. Our next one is ScripthookV. Here's a website here, AB Software Development. You want to scroll down. Where you see this download right here, you want to look, is version 1.0.2372.0, released July 23rd, 2021. Just click the download here. Just see it installing to your desktop. Then you want to get rid of that one. Next up is community ScripthookV.net 3.1.0. I'm going to scroll down. here again, make sure you click this. And see here, it comes up, ScripthookV.net version 3.3.1. Thought for sure that advertisement was gonna pop up, but it did not. Scroll down here, ScripthookV.net zip. You wanna click on this. Here again, it's downloading. We'll put it on our desktop so we can get back to it. After you do that, close out of that. Next up is our Rage plug-in hook. Now there is a Rage plug-in hook on LSPDFR, but we have got to download this one so we can get additional files that are in Rage plug-in hook onto our LSPDFR. So you'll click on download now. It'll come up to show you, make sure you choose the correct game. We want to create the grand, we want to click on the Grand Theft Auto V Legacy. We'll come up this Rage plugin hook 1.87.1293.16189. Click download. See, it's downloading here. And when it gets done, what we'll do is we'll close out of that. Next and last is going to be our LSPDFR. And this is on their own website here, LSPDFR website. What we'll do is we'll go down here. You see it says download LSPDFR 0.4.9. We'll click just download. It'll give us this screen here. What you want to do is you want to go here, click download file. You'll see this download terms pop up. You don't need to read those. Just go and hit agree and download. You'll see to download your files. There's two files here. There's a setup, which we will not do. I highly recommend not doing the setup by EXE. Do the manual install zip. That's the one we're going to be using. You'll see it pop up here in just a second. My computer's a little bit on the slow side tonight, but it'll pop up in just a second. There we go. It takes a little bit of time because it is a pretty large file. So it takes it a minute or two. Hope everybody's doing well tonight. Everybody's doing good. Hope this helps out, get you into the game like you want to. Okay, it is downloading now. So what we're going to do is we're going to close out of that. Bring us to our desktop. Now, what I've got to do, I need to pull all my games, or actually all of my files to my desktop. So I'm gonna click on download. I'm gonna grab them and I'm gonna pull them over here to my desktop. You may already have them on your desktop, but I'm gonna grab and pull them here. Click B and just like that. Pull them over here to the side. Now what we've got to do, we got to go in and find our actual folder where our Grand Theft Auto is in. As you see, I got some here, but I will show you how to do it. Go to your File Explorer and go to where your Grand Theft Auto was loaded. Steam Library. Double click it. My computer's being funny. My F drive may not be installed here, so I'm going to have to unplug it and plug it back up to make sure it is installed. There's sometimes some issues with my S drive. Sometimes it won't show up like it's supposed to. Okay, let's do this again. Steam Library, Steam App, Common, and here is your Grand Theft Auto file. Like, as you can see, I've got several different ones. I got Grand Theft Auto 5. I got a copy here. I got one where I use my firefighter mods, and I got one where I use on my SLRP. Now, important thing here. Your Rage plugin hook will only work with the file called Grand Theft Auto 5. These other ones here, it will not try to pull for them. So, say I want to play my Grand Theft Auto 5 Firefighter, what I will need to do is I'll have to come up here and click behind it, and I'll actually have to come in here and I'll have to rename this PD. When I do that, it will not try to pull from this file anymore. And what I'll do is I'll go to the one that I want to play, which is this one here. I'll right click and get that off and make sure it shows Grand Theft Auto 5. A lot of people are having problems because they may have something behind it here. They may have additional copies in here with nothing behind it. It may have two or three files with just Grand Theft Auto 5 in here. What will happen, your Rage plugin hook will try to pull these files and they end up crashing your game. So you've got to name it this here. You got to name it Grand Theft Auto 5. Nothing behind it. I'm going to come in here for install purposes and I'm going to use my copy here because I've got other copies of the places. And I'm going to name this back Firefighter because I'm not going to install one here. I've already got my stuff installed on these. I'm going to use a fresh copy. This is what a fresh copy should look like. Shouldn't have hardly anything in here at all. It's just a little bit right here. Okay. So now that I've got that up here, I'm going to go back to it. What I'm going to do is I'm going to go up here and I'm going to take this stuff out of here. You can see all the copies that I've actually had. I'm going to take all this out. So this is the one we're going to be using. All right. So I want to left click, right click, send to the desktop. Okay, that's going to put it on the desktop here. I'm going to close out of this. I'm going to go to this file here, which says Grand Theft Auto 5. I'm going to grab it, and I'm going to pull it in to my task board in this file manager here. Okay, you should see it there. It's the shortcut. That shouldn't mess up anything, because that's going to be the one Rage plugin hook goes with. Because if I click on it in the file thing, it's not showing shortcut. Okay, so what I'm going to do here, I'm going to double click on this. It'll pull it up here. This is the one we're going to use. This is a fresh copy. So, we'll pull this over to the side and make this strong here because you're going to need this buffer area right here. You will need this to pull your files into. Because if you don't do that and you have something highlighting clicking in here, you pull it into one of these folders here, it will mess your game up. It will not work. So make sure nothing is selected. Make sure you have room here for your buffer. I'm dipping a little bit, so it's getting out of my mouth. So let's go ahead and start installing some of this. First off, what we're going to do is we're going to install Simple Trainer. Okay. And what you're going to need to do is you're going to need to have Winrar, or you're going to have, I think it's 7-zip files, something to, when you download your files, you can open them up. First thing is Simple Trainer. What you need to do is you need to grab the INI file and the ASI file. And what I did was I held Control down and I clicked on both of these, INI and ASI. This reference the README and the change text, do not need those. What you're gonna do is you're gonna grab them, pull them into your directory, and drop them. And a good habit to do too, every time you do this, is go back and hit this refresh button to make sure everything goes back like it's supposed to be. We're gonna get out of that. We're gonna delete that file. I do recommend making you a new folder somewhere and taking these installs here and putting them into a new folder. That way you can get back to them. You ain't got to install it every time. Next up is our ScripthookV. And mine's going to do this because I've got to go ahead and buy the WinRAR, which I used the free version for a while. Click on that. Click on bin. What we need here, the ScripthookV, we're going to need both DLL files here. We're going to need the ScripthookV DLL and the DINPUT8.DLL. We'll grab both of those. We'll pull them into your file folder. Now this native trainer is just like your simple trainer, except it's not any good. It's crap. You don't want that. After you get that installed, make sure you go up here. You want to refresh. You want to close out of this. You want to click on that and delete it. Get rid of it. Next up is our ScripthookV.net community one. What we're going to do here, we need three files. We need the ScripthookV.net SI, the ScripthookV.net 2.dll, and the ScripthookV.net 3.dll. Remember, ScripthookV.net 3.dll, ScripthookV.net 2.dll, and the ScripthookV.net .asi. Grab those, pull them into your directory, drop them. Just like that. Refresh. Get rid of that. Next up, we're going to do our RAGE plugin hook. We're going to do this in order just like this. We want to make sure we get the RAGE plugin hook that we downloaded in there first. We're going to do the LSPDFR, and I'll show you why. What we're going to do here, we want to grab everything here, and then we're going to unclick on some of these that we do not need. But what I like to do, and you do it the way you want to, but I click on everything, and then I'll come back and I'll deselect no 2.0, no license, no SDK, and no, where it says here, readme text. Do not need those. So again, the 2.0, the license, the SDK, and the readme text. Unselect those. You do not need those. You're going to grab these files, you're going to pull them in your main directory. It's going to download. Yours may take a little bit longer than mine. You'll see all these pop in. You want to refresh, click, make sure nothing's checked. You want to close that out. We want to get rid of that. Last but not least is our actual LSPDFR 04.9. So what we want to do here, we want to select everything again, and then we're going to deselect. But a simpler way to do it, I think you hit Control A or something like that, and you can highlight all of these. But I just do it this way to make sure I get everything. Get all of these. And again, deselect the 2.0, the license. You want to keep the LSPDFR, the plugin, you want to keep all that. You want to go down here to the readme text, deselect that. If you look up above that, you see a RAGE plugin hook exe. Same thing as we just downloaded, but the other RAGE plugin hook, there's a couple more files that we need to help run this. So after we get that, make sure readme text, license, and the 2.0, we do not have to let. I'm going to grab these files, pull them into your main directory. Just like that. It should say copy over here in just a second. And we do want to do that. We want to copy over. What we're actually doing is we're copying a new version of the RAGE plugin hook. Takes a little bit of time. There's a lot of files got to put in the game. It will be done in just a minute. Just say replace 14 files. Yep, look, replace 14 files. Let's replace them. Okay, now with that, make sure you click here. Refresh, nothing to check. Now we can close out of this. Okay, now that we have that installed, what we're gonna do is we're gonna go here and look in the plugins folder here. If you can tell, LSPD is installed now, okay? So everything is installed. Go back to your main folder here, which is a Steam App Common Grand Theft Auto 5. If you scroll down, you see this RAGE plugin hook. you hover over top of it, it shows 1.87.1293 with a date created 10/4/2021. That's when we installed it, but it installed it here 7/21/2021. Then what you want to do is you want to come up here to the RAID plugin hook. You want to left click and right click, send it to your desktop. That way it's a shortcut. Then you can actually close out of your GTA 5 folder. You want to grab this RAID plugin hook and you want to pull it into your taskbar. And you do want it there. That way it's a quick access to you. Mine not going to pin my taskbar. Let's figure out why. Not even staying pinned to the taskbar. Let's just sit here. I think it is. My RAID plug-in hook. There. And what you can do is you can take this and go ahead and get rid of this file. They're not going to need it. Get rid of that file here. They're not going to need it. When you first open RAID plug-in hook, this is going to come up with, please read this disclaimer carefully. You can read it if you want to. But you do want to hit accept. What you're just going to do is, first time installation, it's going to create a backup copy of your game, and you want a backup copy. So your RAID plug-in hook can back up the current game version so you can revert it in case the new version breaks modding functionality. Backup will require about 1,150 megabytes, which is not a whole lot. If you wish to back up your game, I suggest you do hit the yes. It's creating a backup now. And this only happens on your first initial click on RAID plugin hook. You'll see another folder pop up here. An economic system in just a second. Billions below the poverty line. Here is where you do your changes, like on your plugins and all. Whenever you install plugins, you got to make sure that you have this checked. Now, I suggest don't change the console key. You want to keep that F4. But here where it says plugin timeout threshold, I always set mine to 40,000. I know other people like Criminal Justice and them, they set theirs like at 20,000. But the support recommends using 60,000. Use whatever you want to try. Just know that if when you're loading in and the game crashes, you may need to come in here and change this to 60,000. Once you have that, you want to go to your plugins. As you can see here, the LSPD first response is here. You want to click on load these plugins on startup. Check all. Load all plugins on startup. Your advanced settings, make sure nothing is checked. Game settings. Here's where your backup, you can make a backup copy of the current version if you need to. Here is where you revert to the copy is. Like mine says here, launcher version 1.0.0.37 is supported. So mine is good to go. Now after that, you want to go back to here and go ahead and hit save and launch. This screen will pop up, access the setting dialog, go ahead and hit OK. And we'll start getting to the game. You'll see it showing this, and it will be launching the game. Usually I would stop recording here and kind of go back out, but I'm going to let it go ahead and run so you can see what it's going to do. And again, pay attention to the right-hand portion of your screen. You'll see all of my social media stuff pop up. I do highly suggest joining my Discord. Get on my Discord for all your support needs, all your files you need. I will put them up there. Here comes a Rockstar gaming logo popping up. We're feeling alive even when we are slowly dying. times the ScripthookV update. Okay, guys and girls, after we have closed out of the game, after we loaded up, just to make sure it would load in, what we need to do is we need to come in here and manipulate your files so they'll work right, so things won't flash when you play. And I'll show you how to do that, and I'll show you everything you need to do. We need to go down to our folder here, right click, pull up this Grand Theft Auto 5 folder. It's the one that we're going to be using in the game, so that's the one we need to go in and manipulate. We'll click on it, we'll pull it up, we're going to this here where it says LSPDFR. Not any plugins, not updates, LSPDFR. We'll double click. We'll get into here. Should be under Steam App, Common, Grand Theft Auto 5, LSPDFR. Go to Keys. Click on Keys. We'll pull up this here. We're going to go in here. We're going to manipulate files and change them so they don't flash and so they kind of work together. So what we need to do is we need to come here to this none here. We need to highlight it. Get control C to copy it. First thing we need to change is the pursuit menu control key. Pursuit menu control key, which is this one here. Where it says D-pad down, we need to highlight it. Hit control C. That takes none. Next up is our perform arrest key. Perform arrest. Where it says E on the perform arrest key, we need to change that to a capital I. While we change that for us, so if we don't, it will crash our other plugins that we install later on. Such as Drop the Bed, Open It Back Up, Degrade All Light. It will crash for those if we don't change. Like I said, if you change these the way I have them, and there's like other people like Criminal Justice and all them have them like this, it will not mess with other menus and other keys we have here. Okay? Make sure you change it like I've got mine changed. Next, we're going to go to Stop Ped Key. Stop Ped Key, where it says E.
What color need is to your highlight favorite that. Song?
Hit Control
Katy Perry B. knows.
Oop, told
music
you wrong,
color Hunter. Is a collaboration between
we need to make that a
and Bear Paint,
as well.
Bringing the color she
my
experiences
fault,
in music to the Spotify library.
I.
Now, when you listen to your songs,
abort.
You'll
join
see colors e. aligned to musical attributes
taste
like tempo
join.
And key. Discovering the perfect paint color is as easy as pressing play. Visit BearMusicAndColor.com.
We need to change that G and put Control V. We're going to need the G key for something else later on, so we do not want that on there. Next up is take the board, join the controller key where it says D-pad left. We need to highlight that. Control V. Do not want this on your control. Do not want it on your controller. Promise you. Do not want it. Take the traffic start stop controller key. Traffic start stop controller key. Take the here says traffic stop start. Traffic stop start controller key. Highlight that. Take control key. Do not want that on your controller. Promise you. Do not want it. Take the traffic stop interact E where it says E highlight it capital I. Next up is traffic stop interact controller traffic stop interact controller highlight that D-pad. You want to hit control C. Do not want that on your controller either. Next up is toggle computer controller key. Toggle computer controller key. You do not want that on your controller E. You don't want your controller E, just control V. You hit none. Next up is your backup menu controller key. You do not want that on your controller either. Control V for none. You want to go back through and you make double check, make sure you got everything correct. Once you do that, come here, hit file, and hit save. And you can go back in there and just double check, make sure it changed. It all changed for you. So we're done with that. Except we're going to the LSPDFR configuration set. Double click on that, put it up here. Here is where it says main preload all models. Main preload all models. We're going to change that from true to a lowercase font. A lot of detectors and all get messed up if they're on true. There's a big, you'll see a difference from the true to the false. Next, you're going to go to ambient disable escape suspect encounter. Ambient disable escape suspect encounter. You're going to change that from a false to a lowercase true. Case disable camera focus. I'm going to change that also to true. And the reason for that is when you're actually doing something to take somebody, what it's going to do is it's going to turn your attention straight to that case. And it's going to zoom into that chase, and anything else going on around you will completely go off of that. So you want to keep this to true. If you're like me, if not, if you want that to happen, then you can keep it at false. It's okay. But you'll see a big difference if you do keep that true. Next step, we need to go to the ambient disable player flashlight override. Ambient disable player flashlight override. That fault right now, we're going to change that later on. And what that is your flashlight, you'll see a big difference once we load up the different flashlight in here. But that right now, what it's set on. That's it with all of this. What we're going to do is come in here, hit file, hit save, and we're going to get out of there. Okay, after all of that is done, we've done hit raid plugin hook already, so it should go right straight to the game. But if you wanted to check and make sure the plugin was in there ready to go, all you do is click raid. Hope you left gift. The box pop up, your raid plugin hook. Like that. Make sure these feel the same. Click on plugin, load these plugins on startup, make it check all, make sure you go back to load all plugins on startup, and you're good to go. You can go hit save and launch. What I'll do is I'll come back to you once we get in the game. Okay, everybody. Once you come into the game, you should come in here as just like this. What you want to do is go ahead and walk out the door. Get right here. Hit your P button to bring up this menu. And you want to go to LSPDFR. Go over here to go to nearest police station. Once you get in here to your police station, I'm using my controller, so what you want to do is you want to go ahead and come in here to the police station. Get to the door. You go in. This is where you're going to create your player. What it is, we'll go on duty. What it should do is come up and show you. Select character. You need to select a character to use LSPDFR. Would you like to go to character selection menu now? Hit OK. or either you enter on your keyboard. That'll bring you to the screen where you create your actual player that you're going to play with during the game. Okay, what you need to do is you change it to whichever one you are, male or female. Then you go down to heritage. Heritage is going to be your mom and dad. You scroll through here till you pick the one that you want to have. Your dad wants to be, your mom you want to be. And you see that changes your look. Let's see here. Try not to take too long to do that. Who you want to resemble the most, your dad or your mom. Kind of put it about midway. Skin tone. Then we go back out of that. Go to your features. Usually what I do is I make mine just standard. You can go in and change what you want to, like nose, tip, cheekbone, the cheek, the lips, the jaw, the chin shape. You can change all that to whatever you want to, but I usually put it on standard. You go back out of that menu, go to your appearance. Here's where you can change your hairstyle to whatever you want to. A lot to choose from. I usually pick, let's see. I mean, you can pick what you want to pick, but I'm going to pick one I usually pick here. Mm-hmm. The parted hair, that's for sure. That's for sure. I usually do like the spiky one. Change your eyebrows or what you want them to. Face your hair. I usually go ahead with a scruffy beard. Not that. And when you do this, you can go in and you can change your actual color of your hair, what you want it to be. Same as your hair there. And I don't want no red hair. Let's change it to that. And let's change his facial hair to that. So it don't look so red. You can change your moles, freckles, skin damage, eye color. You can change it to emerald. Eye makeup, lipstick, you're a female. And you go back out of that, and there's your player there. Hit save and continue. It's going to pop up where you can go in and change the name. I'm going to change mine to my name. You can change it to whatever you want to change it to. Then you hit the enter. And there it goes, change. Then you go up here and you make sure you hit the player that you created. It's going to carry you back into the locker room. Eventually. Mine's running a little slow today. Drives my player there in the locker room. What we want to do is go to the police locker. Make sure you're on LSPD. Then you can change your uniform. You can go in and change variations, anything you want to change. You want to make an officer, officer two. You know, you can go through these and decide what you want to be. I'm just going to pick officer right now. Inventory, you can change. You can put gun. It don't show it up there. Squat round, you can do all kinds of stuff like that. I'm just going to do mine default. Advanced customization, you can go in and put sunglasses on. Then you can go in and change stuff like you want to. You can see all this stuff where you can change. I'm not going to do anything to that right now. I got mine saved on my other one like I needed it. Same thing with prop. And put different stuff in. You may want to go through and play with that and see what you can change and all. But just click on the one you want to change and then it'll put stuff on like, see, I got a watch on now. Not that. All right, and then you go back out of that. Go back out of that. Then you go to confirm. Then you go to your police garage. In our police garage, there's only one car up here that is ELS compatible. And what it is, that is this car right here. But what you've got to do is you got to go in here to the components. You've got to make sure the extra one's off and the extra two is off, just like that. Then you go here and you select modifications. You can change anything you want to here, like brakes, engine, plate. You can change all of that. So whatever you want to change it to, blue or white. I'm just going to come here and I'm going to hit apply all. that kind of modifies the whole car like that. Then we hit select and continue. And with that, it's gonna bring us out of the garage here. And as you can see there, there's our car here. You would hit the, and see here it shows on duty. What you would do here, I used to do first, I hit my M key, which brings up a menu, my M key. And here on the M key, as you can see, it's got my name at the top. It's the interaction menu. And what I can do here, I go to my police radio, hit enter. Let's see here. I want to be unavailable for calls because I don't want to be taking any calls while I'm, you know, going through the menu. So I'm going to select unavailable for call. With that being said, let's go back out of this. A lot of times your vehicle radio will be on too. And what I usually do is I'll go in here and I'll make sure that is off as well. Actual car radio. I'll make sure it's off. Then go back out of that. I'm gonna show you once I get out of the car. That's a couple of things in the car. Now, to do your lights here, the E key turns on the light and the siren. E key turns them back off. Did it just in light though with the E key. Mine's doing a siren too. So that might be something I need to go ahead and change when I change this menu here. But let's go ahead and get out of the car. As you can see here, I'm just standing normal. A lot of people want to know how people stand as like a cop. You go down here, go get your M key to go back to your menu. Go here to your walk style and you change it over to where it says cop. I didn't get far enough away from my car. Let's get back out of the car. Now with my guy standing there, he should put his hands on his belt. Just like that. See that? Now he's standing like a cop. You can go in there and change that anything you want to change it to. I'm going to use mine standing like that. Now, let's see here. I want to go ahead and if you want on duty. If you come into the game, you're not on duty, you're just wearing plain clothes or you're in an apartment. If you hit the F4 key, it brings up this menu at the top. And that you'll hit, click F-O-R-C-E, type that in, hit enter. What it'll do is it'll take me off duty here. Well, I've got to hit tab, F-O-R-C-E tab, which brings up the whole force duty. Hit enter. As you can see now, I'm just in plain clothes now. Now I'll type that again, F-O-R-C-E, tab, enter. You'll show on duty and I'll be back in my clothes. You can just hit escape key to back out of that. I'm back in my clothes there. Now let's go in here and hit F3, which brings up your simple trainer menu. You want to click options. You can put always guide mode. I don't like to use that. Not for my player. Also, a couple of people use, you scroll down this, look at everything right here, increase warning level. That's not going to be on since you're a police officer. Go through doors is already on. All this is disabled. Player visible is there. A lot of people go in here and they'll turn on stuff like infinite stamina, which when you run you won't lose, like you won't slow down, you won't get tired, so turn that on. Then you want to make sure when you turn that on, all that's right there. Then on your number pad key, not the keys at the top of your keyboard, but your number pad key, 8 goes up, two goes down, six goes left, I mean, six goes right, and four goes left, and five is the enter key. So we want to hit the six key to go over to this menu here. You can look down this menu as well. Keybind is enabled. Player ragdoll is enabled. Player gravity is enabled. Everyone ignore, disable. A lot of people go here and they turn on like different stuff, but we want to make sure we turn on the show Fort Vancouver and prison on the map. You want that on, and you want to reveal the full map. You don't want just a piece of the map there showing up. So you make sure you got it on. Then you want to make sure you go every time you change something. You want to go here and you want to make sure you hit the five key to save the sets. Press number five to confirm or press zero. That is the five on the keypad, not the keys on top of the keyboard, but the keypad. Hit five again. That should take us back out of this. It's saved. Takes us back to the menu here. Then we'll go back out of this. By hitting the zero key, it goes back. Then we want to go to our vehicle options key. Now, vehicle options, I do turn my vehicle on to God mode and then go into vehicle God mode settings. And you see everything's checked, but auto clean. I always keep my auto clean enabled so my car always stays clean. Do whatever you want to do, but I always keep it like that. But you can do what you want to do on that. Here you can fix the vehicle, clean the vehicle. If you didn't have that enabled, you can change your license plate number here. I think the license plate here says something like 4-6. Let's go back here and look. If I can get to where you can see it. It's got 2-4 because I did change it in the actual menu thing over there earlier. Vehicle mode menu. All these on. A lot of people come in here and they change, like, I think it's the next one over. I'll show you that. They'll come in here and they'll change stuff like, let's scroll on down. These are some other things you can change. You can just look through them and see. A lot of people change enable infinite boost so you go a whole lot faster. To me, that's not realistic gameplay. So I do not change the enable infinite boost. I do not change engine power multiplier or set engine power multiplier. That just makes the car go a lot faster. You never lose anybody in a chase and all. But I want to keep mine realistic, so I do not change that. Now, if you did go in here and you changed the engine power multiplier, you can put it up like to 70 or 65 and all, and it gives you like a boost. But like I said, I am not going to change that. I'm going to keep mine just like it is. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back out of that. I'm going to go back up to options. I'm going to go back over using the 6 key. Save settings to trainer. Make sure, like I said, save every time you change something. Hit the 5 key. Hit the 5 key again. It's just going to save it. And should bring me back out. So all my stuff is saved now. Then brings me back to that menu again, which I'm going to go back out. Now here in the game, when you're actually playing in the game, your weapons, when you have stop the pad, stuff like that, it's going to make them realistic weapons where you've got like a flashlight and a gun, and that's basically it. But here, if you do not want realistic weapons, you can come in here and click weapons. You can go down and make sure you have unlimited ammo. And I'm just showing you this so you'll know what to do if you want to have unrealistic weapons. Make sure you have unlimited ammo. And we do want to remove all weapons because we're going to load some more in here. So remove all weapons. Keep that unlimited ammo on. Then you want to go to your weapons here. You know you want a nightstick. And scroll on down. You want a flashlight. And you want a pistol. You can pick any pistol there you want. I usually just pick that one here. You can have a backup weapon if you want a backup weapon. You can put that into. You want a stun gun. And you want to go over and hit your 6th key on the keypad to go over. You want to make sure you get a pump shotgun or any one of the shotguns you want. And then I always get a carbine rifle too, just like that. Then what you want to do is you want to go back by using the 4 key, not the 6 key. Go back over, get all the way back up, and then here you want to go to where is it at? Weapons, attachment, and tent. And if you want to put your flashlight on all your stuff, pistol have the flashlight and everything. As you can see here, this is the carbine rifle. You hit the 6 key to go over to flashlight. You hit the 5 to confirm it. Now the flashlight is added to the carbine rifle, and I'll show you. You hold it up like that. Hit your E key, and see, now your flashlight is on that right there. Go back. You go back in there again. Make sure it still stayed there. Let's see, did it stay on there? I don't know if it did or not. Let's try it again, make sure it stayed up there. Yep, it stayed up there. See how bright that light is? Then you want to go to your wheel. And I go to my wheel by hitting the tab button. Go up to pistol. That's your pull-up pistol here. You see here in the current weapon, it shows pistol. Do the same thing. Flashlight. Enter. Shows flashlight added. Go back to my wheel again. Stun gun, you can't put that on there. And the carbon rifle, I have it on there. And my shotgun, I want to put it on there. So then I hit the 6 key, it's already up there. The flashlight is up there. Hit the 5 and save it, and then go back. And then what I want to do, after I had all that saved right, I want to go down to where it says weapons load and save menu. Click that, save all weapons to slot 1. Everything's saved to slot 1. So when I come back in the game and I don't want realistic weapons, and I want the weapons that I made myself, you go all the way up here to load all weapons to slot 1. Weapons are loaded. So I should have all my weapons now. Nightstick, flashlight, should have everything that I need there. Let me check over my notes to make sure I covered everything there for you. Everything covered. I'll go back here and I want to show you the weather. You can change your weather to what you want to here too. I can click on that. I can make it extra sunny. I can make it clear. I can make it neutral. I can make smog, foggy, overcast, clouds, clearing, rain, thunder. Get thunder here in a minute. If I keep it on that, but I ain't gonna keep it on that. Snow, blizzard, light snow, Christmas, Halloween. Kind of looks freaky. There's your thunder and lightning. Looks pretty good. Forest weather, I got that disabled. Disable the wind. Disable that. Time cycle modifier menu. And cloud menu. I can do different clouds if I wanted to. The time cycle, there's different stuff in here. Clear time cycle modifier. I usually don't mess around with that. But I do mess with my time some. I can change the time of day. Usually don't mess with this here. This puts you in slow motion and stuff like that. It don't like slow the game time down. Like when you're playing, it don't make it like if it's, say, 4 o'clock, it won't slow it down to like make 4:01 come slower. What this does, slows down the way people move in the game. But I can, here you can go to change it to noon. Look how bright it is, noon. Afternoon, evening, nighttime. You can make it go ahead 1 hour, back 1 hour, You can sync to your system here, where I sync to mine right now because it's nighttime. It's almost, I think, 9 o'clock at night. It makes it 9 o'clock here. Real time duration, freeze the time. You can stop time where it don't change at all. You can actually freeze the game where everything freezes. Then you can set your hour to whatever time of the day you want it to be. So let's go back to the weather, and I don't want this rain here. Let's make it a clear, day by that. And the rain will stop. Let me show you about this teleporting. To teleport, say I want to go somewhere on the map, if I click my P button, brings up the map, and you see where I changed the actual map, where I made it big. Now you can see everything. Where if I didn't change that, you would just have like a little portion of the map. But now that I got that, let's teleport over here to the airport. What you do here is you go to where you want to hit, go to, you hit enter. That shows you a way to get there if you want to drive there, but I'm not going to drive there. Hit your P button again to get back out of that menu. Then you hit the delete key. See what that done? Put me at the airport. So now I am at the airport. Now that I'm at the airport, what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to shine my flashlight. Look, got my flashlight, shine my flashlight. That's a bright light too. But let's go ahead up here to the vehicle spawning key here. Here's a bunch of vehicles in here. What we want to go to is we want to go to emergency. Now, once you install vehicles in your game, and we'll do that in another tutorial, you'll go here to the added vehicle menu, and it would show up there the vehicle name that you want to spawn there. But since we hadn't done that yet, we'll go up here to emergency. And it shows you emergency vehicles. Let's go to police cruiser because that's the one that we changed and modified. So we got our police cruiser. Thought we changed it. Maybe I didn't save it. Maybe it's the unmarked. No, it can't be that. Might be because we went out and come back in and didn't save it. Let's go back out of that. And we do want to turn that radio off. Since this lets me show you about the radio. So if you go down here and you go to vehicle and you go down here to this radio, turn it off just like that. This ain't gonna work right with my lights now because I have actually went into the game with this one, and I don't think the other one, the police cruiser, is gonna work right. What I can actually do is I can actually go back to the police station. Let's go back to one of the police stations here. Go to this one here. I tell you what, let's go to this one. That's the prison. Go to this one here. This should be Sandy Shores. I hit the P button to get to the map. Hit the P button again to get back out of it and hit delete. Look, I didn't put the car on top of the building. But we're not going to use that car anyway, so I'm going to hit the F button to get out of the car. We'll leave it on top. And say I don't want to be holding my flashlight in my hand. So what I'll do is I'll hit the tab button to bring my wheel up. And I'll change it to my hands on it. And I'll put the light up. See if we can get down without killing ourselves. And I can get in this building here. But I got to find out where I need to get in this building at. Should be around here. Maybe. Yeah, and get in here. Here, and then go back here to enter back into the police locker room. Once we go there, we can go to the police garage. Don't know why a car didn't save. go back here to component, make sure we turn that off, make sure we do all the modifications, and then we'll go back out. And I can actually show you probably here. I don't have to go back to the airport. Now we'll walk back out the door here. This is the Sandy Shore Police Station. And we'll spawn the car here. Hit your F3 to bring that up. Go to vehicle spawn. Go to emergency. Go to police. You still didn't do it. I know good and well it's not an unmarked cruiser. Police cruiser 2. Police cruiser 3. It all different cars. Let's go back in there again. Should have saved it. Maybe I didn't save it. Maybe I missed a step, didn't save it. But I didn't get out of that menu, so I went ahead and put another car here. Make sure we get out of that menu. Go back in here. Go back to our police garage. I don't believe I saved it, what the problem was. Go back to component. Turn it off. Select and continue. There we go. Now we got it right. All of the cars are gone. So, we'll pull out. Let's pull right here. Still turns the siren on. Which we don't want the siren to be running. And look at my notes, but I thought for sure they just turned the lights on. If you hit your left thumb controller, it turns your light, just your lights on. Hit it again, it turns it off. Scroll P. Okay, I don't have that loaded in here, so you're not going to see the ELS. That's on the plug-in. But once we get to the plug-ins, you'll see that. But right here, we've got hit your E for your light. There he goes. E for the light. Turns them off. J for your siren. E for your light and J for your siren. J again to turn your siren off. E to turn your lights off. It worked this time. I don't know what it was doing the first time. Every time I hit E, it turned on the lights and the siren. Let's see. Now, we'll go out and we'll actually try to stop somebody. I can show you that. If there are any cars here, might have picked a bad place for a car. get it behind this car. If you hit your left, shift key, it puts that red blimp up there. Then we can get that vehicle to stop. Got to get up behind it. I can't see the traffic stop. Maybe they'll pull on over. They never pull over in a good spot. Never. Let's do another one. Maybe we'll get one to pull over in a good spot instead of there. That was a bad spot. We pulled right in the middle of the road. Let's go through here. Get this vehicle. We did a traffic stop, so they should pull over to the side of the road. Once they pull over to the side of the road, you hit the shift I to get the traffic stop. Once you get here, hit the F button and get out. What you can do here, you can come here and you can kind of look. I always hit my V button. And look at the tag here, and then I can go in here and I can hit. I can hold the X button down when I'm in the car, but if I'm not in the car, I hit the. I can always run the. I run the tag while I'm in the car. Get back in the car. Hit the F button to get back in the car. And what I want to, do is hold my X when I ain't got copyright. See, I keep trying to tell y'all things that are not installed yet. But here, what we can do, make sure we get up close enough. Hit your V button so you can look out the front of your car. Kind of see that tag. You want to read that tag. But you can't see it. Can't see the tag. So what you would do is you'd pull up your police computer here, and you would actually run the tag here. But we got to get to where we can see that tag. But let's get out again and see if we can get this work like we need it to get to work. Go to our menu and let's go to police radio, and let's put it. We can put it on our shoulder. We can put it on our chest. We're going to have an earpiece in, or we're going to have a handheld. And I usually like to use a shoulder. Let's see here. Let's see if we can run this tag. We can run a record request. And can we see it in plate here? Looks like 6-5 B-Boy. Nora 461. We hit enter. And you should see it pop up there. Registered to a Christy Munoz. Shows what kind of vehicle it is and everything. So we got the tag that way. Then we come up here. Get out of that. We can come up here and actually we can hit the I button. To speak to the person, say hello, and so anything you want to do, none. that's passed, we can ask them to get out of the vehicle, we can issue a citation, we can ask them for the ID. Let's ask for the ID. And that said Kiflum, but we'll change that later on where it don't say Kiflum, it'll say something else. Now you can use a police, you know, the computer, a radio to perform a license check. So if we want to use the radio, we go M, police radio, check record, and you can actually type her name in. KRISTIMUNOZ. Then we hit enter. This should bring back her information. License valid and no warrants. After we do that, we don't want to punch her. We hit the shift I again. We can issue a warning or dismiss her. Or if we had a ticket, we could actually give her a ticket there. So if you want to do a citation, you click on that and you enter a citation amount. No, but we're not going to do that. Once you get your CompuLite, it'll be a whole lot easier and a whole lot better. Like I said, I'm going to show you how to do that plug-in later on. But here we can dismiss her, and she'll pull off. And we'll go get back in our car. Turn the siren off. I think that's basically all I need to show you on that. As of right now, you should have like the LSPDFR loaded in your game. You can run through here and do some stuff like this. Stop vehicles, just practice with running plates and running tags and all that. And just go through your menus. Like there's your menu key here. Where it shows like your GPS, where it shows you where to get to the police stations and everything like that, the fire stations. The police radio, like I said. Put it on your shoulder, your chest. You make yourself available for calls there. You can request a call. Records check, closed by nearby road. There's your vehicle, go through that, engine on or off, turn it off. Turn it back on, your lights on or off. You can do that here too, headlights on or off. Doors. Don't really know what that does. I don't know if it locks it or what opens it up. I guess if I hit, let's hit the left, the front left, and hit enter. Yep, that opens the door. Hit enter, it closes it back. Emergency lights, you can turn them on and off there, turn on the siren. Police car radio, which is actually the radio inside the car for the music and on. We do not want that on. We do not want that on. That's that menu there. Then you have your inventory. Which you could get that out of the back of your vehicle if you needed it, like a ballistic shield, evidence marker. You can change your settings in here as well. Spawn character to the last play, spawn location random. Action here, intimidate, flash bash, dance, drink coffee, you know, all kinds of different stuff. Your dialogue, you say hi, player move, there's where you do your walk style. Haven't done anything with eliminated clothing. Set the top to glow, apply to eliminate clothing. I hadn't done anything with that. But that's basically your interaction menu there. I think that's all the menus you have except for your F3, like again, which is your simple trainer. We can go in and change stuff there. Hit escape to get out of that. And then, or actually the zero button on your, the number pad, the zero button. And then your F4 to force yourself on and off duty. Your other stuff will come in play later on, like your Q button, if you want to use your complete computer. You can press tab to automatically insert the name of the last suspect and press alternate L as well. Let's see what that says. Let's see. Alt-L, I wonder if that's Alt-L. It puts the last like tag in there. So, that's basically it there. go back out. I'm going to go back out of this here. Basically, everything you need to know right now of first getting into the game. Then you want to hit yes. That'll carry you back out of the game. Like I said, we had some hiccups there, like to start off with. But that's basically going to be all you need to get onto LSPDFR version 0.4.9, the actual installing of it. Had some hiccups from getting through the menus and stuff and making sure the lights work right and all, but that's just going to take you playing around with it and getting familiarized with it. And I really suggest doing that before you put any plugins in at all, is going ahead and get familiar with all the menus. Everything you can do, changing your stuff like you wanted to change it to. And like I said, when in the next day or maybe even tonight, I'll go ahead and do some of the plugins that you can use, like your CompuLite. That's really a good one. Stop the PED and all that. So just install like I showed you how to install it. If you have any questions, please join my Discord. Please subscribe to my page. Please like my page. This is my first tutorial. I hope I explained it good enough for everybody. I hope everybody can get their game loaded in right and can play. Like I said, any questions at all, any concerns, any problems with it, just hit me up on my Discord or send me a comment. I will get back to you as soon as I possibly can. I appreciate everybody joining in and watching this. I hope it helps you out. And until next time, Copenhagen Country is out. And I will be seeing y'all next time when I do the plugins.